Good morning, everyone. It's Stephen Whiteside here from theuptrend.com with today's look at North American stock market trends. In the pre-market this morning, stock index futures on both sides of the border are above fair value. Commodities are mixed. While the energy sector is higher, gold is lower in the pre-market on Tuesday morning. Let's start off with a little housekeeping. This week's going to be a normal week. We'll finish off Friday with a weekend update. On the weekend, there'll be no videos. The markets are closed here on Monday, so we're going to take Tuesday and Wednesday off as well. And we'll be back on Thursday evening to do a complete website update. So no videos this coming weekend, and then we'll be closed next Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday. Let's start off looking at the VIX. The VIX is still on a daily sell signal. That's supportive for higher stock prices. That would change on Tuesday with a close above 1680. Looking at the major index ETFs that we follow, starting off with the Dow Diamonds, we closed higher yesterday. New all-time high for the SPDR ETF and the Qs for the NASDAQ 100. The rest of the market not keeping up. Mid-cap and small-caps had very quiet days yesterday, inside days for those sectors, so not a lot of movement there. Then looking at the Canadian market, looking at the BMO Canada ETF, the Vanguard, and the iShares for the TSX 60, all still on daily buy signals, no change there. No change for the energy sector, trying to hold support here at 820. No change for financials, fairly quiet trading there yesterday. And no change for the gold sector, had an inside day after generating a sell signal on Monday. Now, it's all about technology stocks, so let's walk through the FANG stocks. Facebook traded up to the upper channel line yesterday. We still need to close above 213.29 on Tuesday to give us a buy signal there. No change in trend for Amazon making a new high yesterday. No change in trend for Netflix making a new closing high yesterday. No change in trend for Google. Remember last week we waved off the buy signal on Google, waiting for the next close above the upper channel line. And then we got that on Friday. And so there's Monday and Tuesday. We're still on a buy signal. No change in trend there. Apple Computer traded down to the lower channel line yesterday before recovering. So a close below yesterday's low would give us a new sell signal. And Tesla. Tesla's down in the pre-market this morning. We need a close below 669.89 on Tuesday to give us a sell signal for Tesla. We're certainly not trading down at that level at this present time. Then looking at the Canadian technology stocks that are leading at the moment, we've got Absolute Software making a new high yesterday. Then we're looking at Constellation Software making a new high yesterday, and Shopify. Shopify did not make a new high yesterday, but still on a buy signal, and those are the three main Canadian technology stocks leading this sector higher. And then last up this morning, Sprint. Sprint's up sharply in the pre-market this morning. Looks like they're going to get approval for their takeover, and we're up, last time I looked, I think it was 60% in the pre-market on Tuesday morning. Okay, folks, that is all for this morning's presentation. Have a great day. Next time you'll hear my voice is on Wednesday morning, and at that time we'll take a closer look at the most actively traded North American stocks.